So, hi there everyone, and welcome back to another episode of What Remains Of Edith Finch. My name's Leon, I'm the one looking after you. And yeah, we discovered some more about Sam in the last episode. Is it time to move on? Right, where are we going?
Instead of hiding from death, Sam seemed to go out of his way to meet it.
Oh, here we go. Door. Okay, another hidden area. Ready to eat meals.
After Sam died, my mom and Edie got really close. They'd both lost a lot.
What we got? Divorce contract between Kay and Sam.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like something funny was happening, but only he could see it. I think he saw things the rest of us don't.
Hello? Sam, I told you I don't want to talk right now.
Okay, don't know what happened there.
I wonder what he saw.
Right, we got, I think we got it. Something over here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's fun. Alright, needs to get up there.
I'm worried about a baby being too happy. But I can feel him slipping away.
Sorry about that, Gregory.
I know you did everything you could. Maybe if I hadn't called that night.
Okay.
About everything. I know what happened wasn't your fault.
That was Gregory's story.
I can't imagine my mom ever writing poetry, and yet. A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard.
I've got to obviously try and catch those.
My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met me, we don't need a stepmom or the words that
I now pronounce you husband and wife. Make him cry.
Maybe we're gonna catch them this time.
Thank you.
Leo.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to
come here.
But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Okay.
The wind picked up, and panic geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent. The rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made. The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power. All my father said to this was, make the music louder. I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea and foam. But I didn't, until we found you.
That's Gus's.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
I'm going to assume we're going up this way.
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died. At the time, it was as far away as she could get. Religion was another thing my mom never talked about, but I think it helped her a lot after her dad died. She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad, Sanjay.
I'm surprised we're not.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Louis was born a year later. When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back. And to see kids in the house again. The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that. And for a while, things were good, almost normal.
That looks like a classroom.
But it didn't last. Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle.
Alright, so we've got steps going that way, but we're going to look at this.
After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings. Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
No, didn't mean to put it down. No. I'm having fun trying to figure this one out. Right, so that brings it to there, obviously makes it ready to flicker. Picturing a book, or that he's picturing. That's clever.
I was 4 when Milton disappeared.
That's Milton's story, and I think that is where we will leave it off for this episode. I hope you're enjoying it, and I want to thank everyone for the amazing comments on YouTube and in Twitter, and the support for the series and the channel. This story is fascinating, so please do continue to keep watching, keep hitting that like button, subscribing to the channel if you're new or if you haven't already done so, and as I said, please leave those comments below and share it with your friends. Get them to come and see this and help the channel grow and develop. And if you want to support the channel in any other way, please check out links in the video description for things like Patreon, Amazon wishlists, etc. But until the next episode, bye bye for now.